Hi everyone, this is Ryan, coming to you this week with another traction tip. And today we want to talk about habits. Specifically, we want to talk about keystone habits, or foundational habits as they're also known. You may say, Ryan, what is a foundational habit? Well, a foundational habit is a habit that's so big, so important, so core, that it facilitates other good habits. In other words, if we can get our foundational habits right, it becomes much easier for us to start other good habits. So why is this important? Well, who we are today is a result of what we did yesterday and our habits from yesterday. Who we're going to be tomorrow is a result of what we're doing right now. So to make sure we're the person we want to be a week from now or a month or a year, even a decade from now, we need to look at what we're doing today and making sure we're doing the right things today. And that's where habits come in. So to get started, let's talk about willpower and self-discipline for a minute. You know, there's a common theory going around, and I tend to agree with it, that as people, as humans, we only have a certain amount, a limited amount of decision-making ability every day. We'll call this kind of our self-discipline bucket. That on any given day, we're limited to the number of tough, big, easy, important decisions we can make. You know, the CEO of Facebook, he's famous for wearing the same t-shirt every day. The former CEO of Yahoo, she had a closet full of the exact same dress. Steve Jobs is famous for his jeans and black turtleneck. The main reason they said they did this was because it was one less decision they had to make every day. In other words, they could save one more decision to use on tough stuff at the office. So another way that we can help is by creating habits. In other words, it became a habit for them to get up and put on the same outfit every day, so they didn't even have to think about it. And that's the beauty of habits. Once we start a habit, we almost don't even have to think about it. In fact, one of the definitions of habit says that it's an action that we regularly perform that would be difficult to stop, and typically we do it without even putting much thought behind it. So it's not taking away from our self-discipline bucket. So think about it this way. To start any habit, we need motivation. And hopefully I'm motivating you a little bit today. Motivation is kind of that jump start that we need to get the habit started. After motivation, though, self-discipline has to kick in if we're going to keep doing it. That's when it gets a little tougher. We have to just trudge along and do the work. And at some point, and of course studies out there that show 20 days, 40 days, 60 days, but at some point, that task becomes a habit and it gets much easier again. So it's easy in the early days because we're motivated to get it done. At some point, that motivation though has to turn into self-discipline for us to continue to do it. And then if we stick it out, if it becomes a habit, it begins to be much easier again. So we need to create foundational habits that stick with us, because then life will just get much easier. So you may say, Ryan, what are those foundational habits? Well, most people agree that there's four big primary foundational habits, and most of them have to do with mental, physical, spiritual well-being, because if we're right in those areas, again, life just gets easier. It's easier for us to make good decisions in every other area. So the big ones, let's get started here. Get plenty of sleep. You know, most human adults need 7+ hours of sleep every night. So foundational habit one, get plenty of rest. Number two, wake up early. It's been shown that high performers average waking up about 3 hours before their actual workday begins. So are you waking up early? Number three, exercise. We've got to exercise. You know, Richard Branson, who owns over 300 companies, he was recently asked in an interview, what's the one tip you would give people to perform best, the best business tip you could imagine giving someone? And he said, exercise. That's easy. So make sure you're exercising. Exercising is our third foundational habit. And then number four is eating right, making sure we're putting the right fuel in our bodies. So these are our four big foundational habits. And if you say, Ryan, I've got three of those locked down, I just need to work on one. Great, that's your big goal for the next quarter. Work on that one. If all of those areas are a mess, pick the one you want to work on first, the one that you feel most motivated to conquer. Start with it. And then every quarter, work on a new one. You can easily establish a foundational habit within 90 days. So for the next 90 days, pick one of those and work on it. One way to do this, one tip, is accountability. You're much more likely to stick to something if you have some accountability. So write it down. You're 36% more likely to achieve your goal if you write it down. And then you're 76% more likely to achieve your goal if you build in some accountability by telling someone. So tell someone. You know, I wanted to start waking up earlier, and it was tough those first few days. And then I decided, you know what? I'm going to start texting a friend that wakes up at about the same time every morning when I wake up. So it's almost a race. We see who wakes up the fastest and we text each other that, hey, we're awake, we're up. And so that's a good accountability check built into a foundational habit to wake up early. So I hope this helped. I hope this motivated you just a little bit to get started creating some great foundational habits. And I'll talk to you next time.